I'd read him Adrian Rich poems when I tucked him in at night. I'd sit him down and we would have long dialogues about consent and respect and body positivity. I took him to the fucking Women's March. Hearing myself out loud, I can see that it was inevitable. Every child runs from parental influence, in his case, straight into the arms of Theta fucking Kappa Theta and their toxic male bullshit.
You can't do that.
Do what?
Blame the frat, not him.
God, no. He is totally responsible. That's why I made him plead guilty. But the prison sentence, I wasn't expecting. I don't know what I... Devon is not built for a place like that. You know, when Devon was rushing that frat in his freshman year, he called me one night, sobbing like a tiny baby after being locked in the trunk of a car. He was victimized by that dog-eat-dog, piss-on-the-weak culture they peddled, but when it was his turn to dole it out, apparently he jumped at the chance. So no, Nora. I'm not saying he isn't to blame, but the patriarchy and its institutions sure aren't innocent. Their allure is still so strong and not getting any less so. Even a sweethearted kid can get caught up in the perpetual churn.
It's bad, isn't it? How powerful that all is.
Yes, it is. For now. But we can create change if we have the fucking guts. I want you to ask yourself, Nora, am I thriving? And your sister, is she thriving? Are my fellow young women thriving? Thriving in this culture created by men? Aren't we all suffering? Pushing ourselves to perfection. Taking on too much. Losing ourselves to things that cannot be. And then breaking at the seams. Imagine stepping away from it all. Breaking free, logging off. Imagine spending a few months in an environment where societal pressures are eliminated, replaced only by the simple responsibilities of breathing, surviving, and becoming more truly yourself. And at the same time, creating a world that men don't control. A world of our very own. Tell me, Nora, how does that sound?